With the series of fires that erupted in California, along with all the other devastating natural disasters this year, it's more important than ever to give what you can to charitable organizations. President and CEO of Direct Relief, Thomas Tighe, is here to discuss the impact of your dollars. Thomas, thanks for joining me.
My pleasure, Alex. Thanks for having me.
Of course. So with so many charities out there requesting donations for good reason, how do people sort through them all?
I think that really the two-step process to sort through charitable organizations is, one, find what you care about. No one can tell you that. There's no one answer. It's very personalized, and it can range from art to environment to stray animals and protecting them to what Direct Relief does is humanitarian medical assistance for people in need around the world. So they're all important, but no one can decide that for you. The second step, once you do decide what you care about, it's important to find a group that will put your money to the best use possible in the most efficient way. And there are independent evaluation organizations like Charity Navigator that can help you look at all environmental groups or all medical assistance groups. And then you can have a sense of objective information to compare their track record, their grade or score that is imposed, and really how much money they receive and spend and what they spend it on. That's an important point of reference for a lot of donors, and we find a lot of people find Direct Relief after going through that process, which is great. They make their own decision, and that also kind of lessens the importance of the intensity of the appeals that nonprofits send out, and you know, of different types.
Right, you can sort of navigate it on your own. And something that people might be concerned about or wonder about when they donate is, how do we know that these funds actually go to the victims that we're intending them to go to?
Right, and as you mentioned, with all these large-scale events that really, they're deeply compelling, they're quite disturbing, and when they're, at the same time when there are solicitations that go out about a hurricane or a fire, it's really important, if those solicitations are being made, to clarify that if a person makes a gift, it will be used for that purpose. I think sadly, a lot of times in these high profile emergencies, there will be a conflation of, you know, look at this awful image of the hurricane, give us money. And there's not necessarily, with no promise to use the money for that event. So you've got to look at the fine print and ask the tough questions if a nonprofit is doing that. We Direct Relief does not do that. We condemn it. We think it's ethically wrong. It can be legally wrong. But typically there's a disclosure that says that we the nonprofit who's doing this, reserves the right to redirect these funds wherever we deem it will do the most good. That is often inconsistent with the front level appeal for, you know, help Hurricane Michael victims. So you've got to read the fine print, sadly, and protect against those sort of baiting and switching.
Right. So it's about doing your research, and also there's so many different ways to give now, from Facebook to adding an extra few dollars to your checkout at the grocery store, etc. You're recommending cut the middleman and just go straight to those charities that are making a difference.
Yeah, I think it's, well, the transparency is there. The rules are clear. If a nonprofit receives any gift, it's got to document that. It's got to receipt the person who gave it. And it will be tracked according to a standard. Also, I think now in the past year, Facebook and PayPal have created a mechanism so you can make a contribution to a nonprofit organization with no transactional costs at all. They absorb all the costs, the credit card processing fees, for example, that are usually at least 2%, if not as high as 4%, if not more. So those are good channels to consider making donations after you've found a charity that you care about.
Well, there's so many different causes to give to out there. I mean, especially like I mentioned with these disasters, our fellow countrymen and women need us. So, Thomas, thanks for what you're doing, and thanks for your time this morning.
My pleasure. Thank you.
Of course. Stay where you are. We'll be right back.